So this time, what I'm going to do, because I have such strong plastic from fusing it, is I'm gonna run it through the sewing machine, and I'm gonna make my pocket that way. A sewing machine is a kind of tool that's been around for a very long time, and is used in order to create things like the clothes that you wear, or the bag, the backpack that you carried, even the covers to the seat in your car. And we're gonna use this tool, the sewing machine this time, to also make a pocket, but we're gonna sew it instead of fuse it. So I have my plastic that I've put together, and I'm gonna cut out the shape that I want to use, similar to how I did before. And I'm just cutting it basically into a rectangle that I'm gonna fold over. So it looks like this. And I notice I have a couple pieces here that are not sticking still. So I'm gonna put those back in on my piece of parchment and fuse those so they get nice and stuck together. Hear all those pops from the bubble wrap. That's really fun when you get to pop the bubbles like that. Okay, let it cool. Okay, now we'll peel it. Okay, so here's my piece of plastic. So I'm going to fold it in half, just like I did for our last pocket. But this time what I'm going to do, instead of just fusing the edges, I'm gonna actually run it through the sewing machine, okay? And when we use the sewing machine, oftentimes we sew things inside out so that we don't see the seams or the edges. So I'm gonna flip it this way, so the wrong side, or the side that you don't necessarily wanna look at that doesn't have the pattern, is on the outside. I'm gonna fold it in half, and I'm going to put this into my sewing machine, and I'm gonna sew here and here. And then we're gonna turn it inside out in order to create our pocket. Okay, so I'm gonna come over to the sewing machine. Some things to think about when you're using the sewing machine is keeping your fingers away from the needle when it's moving up and down. It's very important. The sewing machine has a motor inside of it, and that motor will use the pieces, they're called the feed dogs, against the presser foot to pull the fabric through on its own. You don't have to do that. You don't have to force it through or pull it through. The sewing machine will do it on its own, okay? So when we are going to sew this, we want to keep our fingers away from the needle and just let the machine pull our fabric or our plastic through. So I'm gonna put it down here and put the presser foot down, and that's going to pinch the plastic between the presser foot and the sewing machine. I have a pedal down here for my foot, and when I push on the pedal, it's going to have the needle move up and down and pull that plastic through. So here we go. Keeping my fingers away from the needle. Okay, I'm gonna lift the presser foot here, pull this out, and cut it. And there I just sewed our fused plastic. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. I'm gonna run that through. Again, put the plastic down here between the presser foot and the feed dogs. Push on the pedal. Lift it up. And now I have a seam on both sides. I'm gonna trim those a little bit so we don't have so much of that seam. Okay, and now I have a pocket. But if I really wanna see the exciting colors that we put together on the other side, I can turn it inside out so that we don't see the seams. And now we have a pocket. So we could use this idea and these techniques and create bigger pockets. We could put pockets on our pockets. So we could put another little pocket on top of here if we wanted to. We could put a strap on this and maybe turn it into a bag.